FeiyuScorp Mini 2 Unboxing. This is the outer packaging of FeiyuScorp Mini 2. Open the box to find the manual, the main body, a tripod, to fix the plate, the mobile phone holder, slider, the quick release plate, accessories packs. These are all the accessories included with SCORP Mini 2. FeiyuScorp Mini 2 Introduction to Accessories. There are 7 installation and fixing accessories for SCORP Mini 2. When pairing with mirrorless or compact cameras, there are 2 installation methods, horizontal and vertical. For horizontal installation, use fixed plates, sliders, and quick release plates. For vertical installation, use sliders and quick-release plates. It is recommended to install a lens support bracket for mirrorless cameras. When installing an action camera for horizontal filming, the recommended configuration includes a fixed plate, a slider, a quick-release plate, a GoPro adapter, and a long thumb screws. Action cameras do not require a fixed plate when positioned vertically. When installing a mobile phone, you only need to use the mobile phone holder. FeiyuScorp Mini 2 Horizontal Camera Installation. To horizontally install the camera, you need a fixed plate, a slider, a quick release plate, and a lens bracket. First, unlock the tilt axis and roll axis motor locks. Position the 3 axes to a balanced state. Relock the tilt axis and roll axis motor locks. Unlock the sliding arm lock. Pick up the fixing plate. Slide the fixing plate in, as shown in the video. Relock the sliding arm fixed lock. Pick up the slider. Slide the slider in, as shown in the video. Lock the slider fixed lock. Take the quick release plate in the camera and assemble them together. Take the lens holder and fixing knob and assemble them with the camera. Unlock the safety lock of the quick release plate. After sliding the assembled camera in, as shown in the video, relock the quick release plate safety lock. By following these steps, you have now assembled the camera for horizontal filming. Thank you for watching. FeiyuScorp Mini 2 Removing the camera from horizontal installation. To remove the camera, start by unlocking the safety lock of the quick release plate. While holding the anti-release lock, slide the camera out. Then unlock the slide lock. While holding the anti-release lock, slide the slider out. Finally, unlock the sliding arm fixed lock. While flipping the sliding arm to prevent accidental release, slide out the fixed plates. Then you can remove the camera successfully. Thank you for watching. FeiyuScorp Mini 2 Vertical Camera Installation. To vertically install the camera, you need a slider, a quick release plate, and a lens bracket. First, unlock the tilt axis and roll axis motor locks. Position the 3 axes to a balanced state. Relock the tilt axis and roll axis motor locks. unlock the sliding arm lock. Pick up the slider. Slide the slider in as shown in the video. Lock the slider, fix the lock. Take the quick release plate and the camera and assemble them together. Take the lens holder and a fixing knob and assemble them with a camera. After sliding the assemble camera in, as shown in the video, we lock the quick release plate safety lock. By following these steps, you have now assembled the camera for vertical filming. Thank you for watching. FeiyuScorp Mini 2 Mobile Phone Installation. First, unlock the stabilizer tilt axis and roll axis motor locks. Position the three axes to a balanced state. Relock the tilt axis motor lock and roll axis motor lock. Unlock the sliding arm lock. Slide the phone holder in, following the instructions in the video. Relock the sliding arm lock. Pick up the phone and place it in the phone holder. The holder can be rotated to switch between horizontal and a vertical filming. Thank you for watching. FeiyuScorp Mini 2 GoPro Camera Installation. To install a GoPro, you will need a fixing plate, a slider, a quick release plate, long thumb screws, a GoPro adapter, and a GoPro body. First, unlock the tilt axis motor lock and roll axis motor lock. Position the three axes to a balanced state. Relock the tilt axis motor lock and roll axis motor lock. Unlock the sliding arm lock. Pick up the fixing plate. Slide the fixing plate in, as shown in the video. Relock the sliding arm, fix the lock. Pick up the slider. Slide the slider in, as shown in the video. Lock the slider, fix the lock. Pick up the GoPro adapter. Pick up the GoPro. Install the GoPro adapter, as shown in the video. Pick up the long thumb screw. Pass it through the hole on one end of the GoPro adapter and tighten it. Plate with screws. Ensure the direction of the quick release plate is forward. Screw it into the bottom of the GoPro adapter. And tighten it with an inner hexagonal wrench. Unlock the safety lock of the quick release plate. Slide the assembled GoPro camera in, as shown in this video. Lock the quick release plate safety lock. The installation is complete. Thank you for watching. SCORP Mini 2 Balancing Tutorial. Begin by unlocking the Rolex's motor lock. After unlocking, expand the Rolex's arm. Relock the motor lock. Now, unlock the tilt axis motor lock. Lower the axle arm and lock it. At this point, the stabilizer is in a balanced lock state. Begin by unlocking the tilt axis motor. Ensure the camera lens is pointing vertically upward. Observe the camera tilt direction. If the camera lens is tilted to one end, it indicates a biases in the center of gravity. Unlock the sliding arm fixed lock. Move the sliding arm in the opposite direction of the tilt until the camera lens is vertically upward, achieving vertical balance on the tilt axis. Lock the sliding arm fixed lock at this point. Keep the camera lens facing forward horizontally. Again, observe the camera tilt direction. If the lens is tilted, it indicates a center of gravity bias. Release the quick release plate saver lock. Move the camera in the opposite direction of the tilt until the lens remains level and facing forward, completing the front-to-back leveling of the pan axis. Tighten the quick release plate safety lock. Now, we lock the tilt axis motor lock. Open the Rolex's motor lock. Observe the camera tilt direction. If the camera lens is tilted to one end, it indicates a bias in the center of gravity. Loosen the cross arm fixing knob. Move the camera in the opposite direction of the tilt. Until the cross arm remains horizontally balanced. Now, the Rolex is successfully balanced. Tighten the roll arm fixing knob. Lock the Rolex's motor. Open the yaw axis motor lock. Hold the handle and tilt the gimbal. If the camera lens is tilted to one end, it indicates a bias in the center of gravity. Loosen the vertical arm fixing knob. Move the camera in the opposite direction of the tilt. Until the vertical arm maintains a horizontal balance. Now, the pan axis is successfully balanced. Tighten the vertical arm fixing knob. After balancing all the axes, ensure the camera remains stationary. Keep the horizontal arm level. Keep the vertical arm level. This indicates that all balancing is successful. FeiyuScorp Mini 2. Introduction to button operation and appearance. The SCORP Mini 2 gimbal incorporates a multinational knob, knob function switch key, FPV key, F1 key, pan axis motor, slider anti-lock, roll motor lock, Rolex's motor, quick release plate safety lock, sliding arm fixed lock. Motor lock. FeiyuScorp Mini 2. Introduction to follow mode. Default pan following mode at startup. In the pan follow mode, the camera follows the left and right movements of the hand. In the pan and tilt follow mode, the camera follows the left and right movements of the hand, as well as the movement of the hand in the up and down direction. It does not follow the hand roll direction. Switch to the FPV mode. The camera follows the movement of the hand in any direction. Switch to the lock mode. The camera will not follow head movement in any direction. Switch to the flash follow mode. The camera follows the movement of the hand in any direction, and the follow speed is increased. FeiyuScorp Mini 2 Basic Tutorial. For using the SCORP Mini 2 gimbal, before using the gimbal, ensure that the balance adjustment has been completed and the 3-axis motor locks have all been unlocked. Long press the power button to turn it on. Double-click the power button to enter sleep mode when the camera is powered on. Wake it up by pressing the power button again. The motor strength is displayed on the main screen interface. The adaptive motor strength can be set, or the motor strength of each axis can be adjusted individually. Follow speed. Set the following speed with customizable options. Swipe right to return to the previous level. Follow mode. Set the gimbal following mode. Hand follow. Pan and tilt follow. FPV follow. Lock mode. Flash follow mode. Available scenes. Explore scenes. On the main screen interface, swipe left to right to set shooting parameters. Swipe button to top to configure settings related to multi function knob. Swipe right to left to adjust the joystick, the gimbal, and more settings. Click the mode button to switch between pan follow and pan and tilt follow and FPV follow. Five-click the mode key to enter the horizontal calibration. Double-click the F1 key to switch to vertical shooting mode. Click the FPV key to enter and exit FPV follow. Double-click the F2 key to quickly enter flash follow mode. Click the F2 key to return to main page quickly. Click the F2 key under the home page to lock the screen. Click the F2 key again to unlock the screen. Double-click the trigger button to return to the center. Click the trigger button 3 times to enter selfie mode. Click it 3 times again to exit selfie mode. click the trigger button 4 times to switch the rail axis to the front position. Click the trigger button 4 times again to switch the rail axis to the rear position. Press and hold the trigger button to enter lock mode. Release the trigger button to exit lock mode. Twist the Modi function knob to control the tilt axis angle. Click the knob function key to control the tilt and pan and roll axis angle. It is now switched to control the pan axis angle. Push the joystick to control the tilt and pan axis rotation. Thank you for watching.